Tools required: flathead screwdriver, 7/8 wrench, 1-inch wrench, 5/16 nut driver, needle nose pliers, and a bench vise. Start by unthreading the guide cap on the Miller power pin. Using a pair of pliers, pull the liner from the gun. This works best when the gun is laid out straight without bends or kinks in it. On the back end of the gun, use a flathead screwdriver to remove the screw insulators. Remove the black power pin insulator. Use the 5/16 nut driver or flathead screwdriver and remove the housing screws. Remove the housing from the handle. Using a pair of needle nose pliers, remove the terminals from the rear housing. Place the control plug and the rear housing off to the side. Slide the handle back until the cone and cone nut is exposed. Take your 1-inch wrench, place it on the power pin body, and the 7/8 wrench on the cone. This is the second hex from the cable. Unthread the connection. Place the power pin off to the side. On the front of the gun, remove the housing screws with your 5/16 nut driver. Remove the switch housing and slide the handle back to expose the cone and cone nut connection. Using your needle nose pliers, remove the switch from the housing. Then remove the terminals from the switch. Place the neck into a vise. Be careful not to put too much pressure on the neck aluminum, since you could potentially crush it. Use a 7/8 wrench and turn the cone hex counterclockwise. Spin the cable as you unthread this connection. Remove the neck. You can now start the flip-flop process. At the opposite end of the gun, thread the neck into the cone and cone nut connection until it's snug. Place the neck into the vise, again without damaging the aluminum. Use your 7/8 wrench to thread the connection back onto the neck to a torque spec of 18 foot-pounds. Again, make sure you spin the cable as you're doing this. Remove the neck from the vise. Using a pair of needle nose pliers, place the lead terminals back onto the switch. Place the switch back into the housing by aligning the grooves. Pull the handle back up over the neck body. Align the handle and housing holes with the threaded holes of the neck body. And using your 5/16 nut driver, reinsert the housing screws. On the old front end of your gun, reinsert the Miller pin and body until snug. Use a 1-inch wrench on the power pin body and a 7/8 wrench on the cone hex and thread it to a torque spec of 18 foot-pounds. Reinsert the lead terminals onto the rear housing, keeping in mind that these are not polarity sensitive. Slide the handle forward. Align the handle and housing holes with the threaded holes on the power pin body. Using the 5/16 nut driver, thread the housing screws back in place. Place the power pin insulator back over the pin body and place the screw insulators back on the screws. Lay the welding gun out straight with consumables removed. Reinsert your liner using short strokes to avoid kinking. Push until the liner retainer is flush with the pin and reinsert your Miller guide cap. Dress the liner as required. You've doubled the life of your gun. And your flip-flop is complete.